Woo! What's up, you guys? Today, I'm gonna talk to y'all about one of my favorite saltwater fishing lures, and that is the MirrOlure. Today, I have my, I picked out like some of my favorite MirrOlures that I like to use and that I'm gonna be using for catching those big old speckled trout, the gator trout. So the MirrOlure, just to kind of get right to it, is arguably also like one of the easiest lures to use, especially for saltwater fishing, for redfish and trout, speckled trout. Christy and I, we fish a lot of soft plastics, fish a lot of Z-Man, a lot of Berkeley Gulp, and sometimes the soft plastics aren't always going to be, you know, what's going to get the job done. To be an effective angler, I say, you know, you have to be versatile. You know, you just can't be one dimensional. You can't just fish one type of lure. So these MirrOlures, this is the prime time for me to talk to y'all about fishing these MirrOlures, because now when it starts to get cold, November, December, so those big trout that we all want to target, these MirrOlures are what is going to get the job done. Talk to y'all about how to fish it, how to set it up, everything. Pretty basic. What it's going to do is it's going to sink in the water column, and then when you twitch it, it's going to, you know, just kind of have that motion of a struggling or like dying bait fish, which when this water gets cold, that is spot on. That's what these big trout are gonna be looking for. So that's kind of the first tip for all of these MirrOlures, is whatever you're using. So I personally like to use a slow sinking twitch bait. You can also have the suspending, you can have the subsurface walkers. There's MirrOlure makes tons of, you know, different variations. So I like to use a loop knot, and it's a little difficult for you to see it from here, but a loop knot, I feel like that this loop knot, it gives the bait more of a natural action in the water. This is the MirrOdine. So this profile bait, as you can see, going from here to here, this right here is going to resemble more of a speckled trout's diet as they grow to that, you know, mullet, menhaden, and, you know, that just kind of their main forage, their bait fish. So I really, really like the MirrOdine. This is also a slow sinking MirrOdine as well. So just to kind of talk about how to fish it, there's a lot of different ways that you can fish them. It's so easy. It's just like a soft plastic. But if you can imagine this bait in the water column, as soon as it hits the water, it's gonna just sink nice and slow at a nice steady fall rate. And then what I like to do about every 2 to 3 seconds is I actually point my rod tip down. Typically, I'm pointing my rod tip down and I am just twitching every, it just depends. Honestly, I kind of let the fish tell me which cadence that they like. I like to play around with it. Sometimes I'll let it sit for almost like a 2, 3, even 4 second count. As the water temperature gets cooler, as the year progresses and you're targeting those big gator trout in late December and it's just dead cold, then I'm actually going to give this almost a 5 to 7 second count. That's, so I'm going to throw it in and I'm just going to let it sink. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Twitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Twitch. So that's how I'm going to work this bait as the weather gets cooler and as the season progresses. It really, again, just drives these fish insane, just drives them bonkers. But what you're going for is that reaction strike as the water temperature gets cooler. So that's where, again, the soft plastics are not always going to be the answer when you're inshore fishing. These hard plastics are going to come into play, and you have to learn how to fish these if you want to be successful 12 months out of the year and, you know, just be a versatile angler, not be one dimensional. So I really encourage you guys to start fishing MirrOlures and to just be more well versed in MirrOlures and in hard plastics. So the MirrOdine, again, is going to have that same action. this one just, again, it's just a little bit more of a different profile. The speckled trout's diet, again, it's going to change more from their smaller bait fish, and they're going to focus on larger meals. And as the weather gets colder, then they're going to be a little bit more picky. They're going to be a little bit more selective because they're not going to be as active. So they're going to want something that's right in front of their face, that's an easy meal, but also something that's going to fill them up. There's stories of speckled trout where you'll see them almost like dying because they've tried to eat something so big, and it was like a mullet about this big, huge. So for a 30-inch, you know, 25-inch gator trout, having a larger profile bait is honestly something that you want to do, especially if you are targeting that larger trout. So that's where I really enjoy this. This is probably my favorite MirrOlure to target the gator trout. So, but again, so as the speckled trout get larger and their diet changes, then that's where this one, which is the 32 XXL MR. So this lure right here is gator trout candy. So this one is also a slow sinking twitch bait. This lure will work great all year round. However, in the winter time, in the cooler months, this is going to be your go-to. So I have actually, you know, two color patterns. I have the natural, you know, color pattern right here, and then I also have this one, which I feel like for whatever reason, speckled trout love their like bright colors, love their candy colors, especially when it comes to, you know, their soft plastics. And it also applies to hard plastics. These lures, you can really, like I said, so I'm gonna fish these typically with my rod tip down, and I'm going to twitch every about 2 to 3 seconds. And then again, in the winter, that cadence will increase to 3, 4, 5 plus seconds with these. So this one, again, is just gonna have that action of it slow sinking, 2, 3, 4, twitch, 2, 3, 4, twitch. So the other color pattern that I like is this one, which is, it's got the red head and then it just has like a natural body to it. For whatever reason, these ones work very well as well. This is the MirrOdine. And I also like these hooks right here. They're a little bit less stout than these ones, which are on the double XL. A lot of people do modify their MirrOlures, especially the first thing that they like to modify is the treble hooks. Again, for speckled trout, which kind of leads me into the next kind of topic with these MirrOlures, is with speckled trout, you really have to finesse these fish. You know, they're paper mouths. That's what people call them, you know, paper mouth. And, you know, these speckled trout, you cannot hoss these fish around. You can't really like boat flip these fish as easy. And especially if you get that large speckled trout, you really got to play that fish. You really got to finesse it. So a lot of people, what they'll do is they'll actually downsize in their treble hooks. Okay, so again, just techniques for fishing these MirrOlures, whether it is a MirrOdine or the just classic, the 52 MR. The rule of thumb, easiest thing that you want to do is I either am pointing my rod tip down or I'm actually going to be working at like a soft plastic. Because these are slow sinking, I think one of them that I have is a suspending twitch bait. But, you know, a lot of the fishing that I do, and I would imagine that y'all do, is shallow water flats fishing. So if you're fishing, say, 2 to 3 feet deep water, and you're fishing over an oyster bed, then you do not want to point your rod tip down, because that's going to keep, you know, your lure down in the water column, which will increase your hookups to oyster. So that's where I would, you know, recommend actually working it almost like a soft plastic, just like a jerk bait. So I'm gonna, instead of having my rod tip pointed down and I'm gonna be not jerking it to the side, then I'm actually gonna have it up, and that lure is gonna have this action where it's going. So that was a really bad example. Maybe what I can do is use some of these flowers that I bought for Christy. Yeah, that's right. I buy my wife flowers. Okay, I'm not trying to brag or anything, just trying to spread some positive vibes. All right, so let's say that these flowers are like grass that you're trying to keep your lure above. So you can feel it if you're jerking it and it's gonna get hung up in the grass. What you wanna do is, by keeping your rod tip up, then you will be able to keep that lure above the grass and in the water column. And so that's what you wanna do is, you know, again, a lot of these speckled trout, they are going to be, you know, feeding right in those shallow grass flats, whether you're Tampa, Texas, North Carolina, Virginia, wherever, you know, trout love their grass. And these MirrOlures, whether it's the suspending or the slow sinking, they allow you to keep your bait in the water column and right above the grass where the speckled trout are. That's pretty much it. Again, it's a very, very easy bait. I would love to hear some feedback from y'all. I'm going to be doing a lot more tutorials. This is just kind of one to get y'all started and hopefully to get y'all fishing these MirrOlures. And the last thing I'll say for the setup that I use with these, I actually prefer, this is my favorite Phantom 7'2", and it has some kind of stout, you know, action in the base of the rod, but the tip of the rod is really, really your main focus. You do not want a rod that has like that heavy action in the tip. You want one that has like that light action in the tip. That's super important when you're fishing these MirrOlures, especially with the treble hooks, because you will lose speckled trout. You will rip the hook out of the trout's mouth. And that's just not gonna be fun. It's not gonna be fun for you or the fish. So that's it. That's my recommendation for y'all, is the XXL MirrOdine. Also just the MirrOdine right here, and the 52MR, just classic MirrOlure with the you know, baby trout color. So that's all I got. Thanks you guys for watching. If you haven't subscribed, then please help us out with this channel. Give us a like, give us a subscribe, and also comment below, send us an email and let us know what you'd like to see. That's all I got. So you guys get up off your butt, put these MirrOlures to use, and go catch yourself a big old speckled trout. Send in the picture to our Speckled Trout Derby and win yourself some Florida Fishing Products free gear and some other free gear and prizes. All right, y'all. Peace out.